Us in our writing, and well, I guess it's almost a way of telling you where we steal our tricks from. This is a song that Bad Company did. And I used to walk in these little bars, and there was a band called Richie Sambora and Friends, and it seems every time I come in, he'd sing this song. I guess he's either, he had an inspiration or he was waiting for me to die.
Well, no, I used to sing it for John Lewis, I used to sing it. He's
going
to sing it again.
That means we're going steady. Come on.
Thank you.
How's that guy doing tonight?
Thank you.
JD, why another? This is JD, he'll be making appearances tonight. He's my guitar tech, he wants to be a movie star. Know this one. We'll start a full round of acoustic version of this one. I wanted to tell the world, I think, what it was about. I had to face the truth a little bit myself. So when we got the idea to write this, I had a friend of mine who got married very early in life. He couldn't have been but 18 years old, and his girlfriend called him up one day at college and she said she was pregnant. And he did the right thing. He did the right thing. He packed up those baseball cleats and he put the glove away and he ran on home. And he got married. And it's not a sad ending, it's a very happy ending, because looking back on the 10 years, he's got two beautiful kids and a wife. He's got a house and a job. He puts dinner on the table and when he comes home, you know those kids say, I love you, daddy, and that's pretty good. But sooner or later, everybody's got to grow up. Maybe I'm just starting to face that reality myself. So I came to terms with it, and I decided that although the names have been changed to protect the innocent, but innocence there were left, I make long distance dedications to my good friends, and I hope they're safe. So for them, for Tommy and Gina,
now his heart's all in. What a sad case. more. I will not fear. I feel like a dog. And you can't hear. I should die. I feel a little bit of a fear. Love is here. Sing it! Love is here! I thought I'd be the one. I could have let my fingers to the one. I could have said it. You can't get your fish. You can't get out of love. Love is here.
Liked it enough to use it. It'll be out in June, and if it's okay, we want to play it for you right here, right now. So all you guys rolling your bootleg tapes, hold them up high. All you critics that are gonna cut the shit out of me having fun, get your pencil sharpened. As long as you people keep coming back, we don't need nobody else.
Oh, Thank you.
pay a quarter if you want to use that machine. Fuck no, I don't trust you. You never paid me back the last 18 million quarters I loaned you through your bullshit. We got a working bar back here. Anybody need a cold beer? It's an expensive bar. RT's back there. You gotta tip him well. I think we should play some of this stuff from the albums because that's what the people do know. This is something off the Slippery When Wet album.
Yeah.
pull up and ask me what's the favorite song that we have that we've written. And so far up until today, including tomorrow, is this. Do it. in 15 minutes, we got some surprises for you. We'll be back.
Thank you.
something that the Supremes did a zillion and a half years ago. Maybe you guys heard the Vanilla Fudge version, maybe you heard the Rod Stewart version. Well, now you're going to hear the Bon Jovi version. Check it out.
Maybe it's just a little bit of both, but maybe a little possession.
Tico and I were living in an apartment building in Philadelphia. We were sitting there being miserable with no money and no one to care about nothing because it seems that a bunch of guys in his band went through some hateful divorces. And it was something that I wrote all about that, and it's called Silent Night.
Yeah.
Fogerty wrote, I think he wrote one of the chapters in the book of rock and roll. This one's called Traveling Man.
Thank you. Thank you.
How about a nice hand for the talent of London horn section I've just got? The name was stolen from our keyboard tech. Marty gets a credit. It's a song that Bob Dylan wrote. We're stealing it. It's called 7 Days.
Thank you.
This is like one of those special moments in your career, you know, because you get to jam with some people once in a while, and I think Bill Les Paul had in mind when he styled this guitar was for this man and for this band, a living legend, ladies and gentlemen, Jimmy Page.
I am loving you.
We really thank you very much for coming and helping out the music therapy. It's been a really good cause, you know that. I'm really pleased to have been able to do this for them. I'm really pleased to have done it for you. So one more time, with a little help from my friends and the master. This is
you
sure.